In this video, we will talk about how to add labels on bar plot like this and also like this. So please stay tuned. First of all, we import Matplotlib package, which is a package for plotting in Python. So we import Matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Then we define two variables, day and the temperature of each day. And the days are the days of the week, Saturday all the way up to Friday. And the temperature is the corresponding temperature of each day. For example, the corresponding temperature of Saturday is 30, the corresponding temperature of Sunday is 32, and etc. So here we have defined two variables, day and the temperature. And we want to plot a bar plot, which the x values are the days of the week, and the height of each bar is the temperature. In order to plot a bar plot, we can have two approaches, the stateful approach and the stateless approach. So let's talk about the stateful approach. And after that, we are going to talk about the stateless approach as well. But now let's start with the stateful approach. In order to plot a bar plot in the stateful approach, we simply type plt.bar because we want to have a bar plot. And the x-axis, I mean the values on the x-axis, is the days of the week, and the height of each bar is the temperature, I mean the corresponding temperature of each day. And also let's pass face color and edge color of each bar. The face color of each bar, for example, let's consider light gray, and the edge color, for example, black. And if I simply type plt.show in order to show the plot, you can see that here is our bar plot. Now, in order to add value labels in the center of each bar, in the bar plot, we should simply store the results of this line in a variable, let's say, for example, called bar plot. And then we simply type plt.barLabel, and we should pass a couple of arguments. The first argument is the name of our bar plot. So this is the name of our bar plot, which is bar plot. And then the labels that we want to show is the temperature of each day, and the labels type is center because you want to put the labels on the center, in the center of each bar. So if I run a code, you can see here is the result, and the labels is in the center of each bar. But if you want to put the labels on the edge of each bar, I mean on the top of each bar, you can simply replace center with edge. And if you run the code, you can see that here is the result. But maybe you want to have some distance between the edge of each bar, I mean top of each bar, and the label. In order to do so, you can simply pass another argument, which is padding. And for example, you can provide 3, 2, 5, or whatever number you want. For example, let's pass 3, and if I run the code, you can see now we have a padding of 3. But as you can see, this chart doesn't look good because, you know, the Y limit of this chart is not proper because of these labels. And for example, if you change the limit of the Y axis, for example, to 0 all the way up to 36, or let's say 37, then the labels are going to be more beautiful. So let's change the Y limit. So we simply change the Y limit from 0 all the way up to 37. And if I run the code, now we can see the chart is now better. And also, if you want to rotate these xtick labels, you can simply type plt.xticks. So you can simply type plt.xticks, and you should pass a rotation, for example, equal to, let's say, 45. And if I run the code, you can see that we have rotated the xtick labels. And also, you can rotate these values as well. So for example, you can pass, for example, rotation equals to 45 to this bar label. And if you run the code, you can see also these labels have been rotated. Now let's talk about the stateless approach, which is very similar to the stateful approach. In order to do so, we simply type plt.subplot, which returns two values. The first one is our figure, and the second one is our axes. And we want to plot a bar plot on our axes, so we simply type axes.bar. So I should copy this line, and I want to store the results of this line in a variable, let's say called bar plot. Let's say called bar plot. And then we simply type axes.barLabel. Again, I copy this line, and plt.show in order to show the chart. So I deleted these lines, and you can see that we have only the stateless approach. So if I run a code, you can see here is the results. And also you can change the y limit. So I should simply type ax.setyLimit, not y limit, because in the stateless approach, we have set y limit. And here we should pass 0, for example, all the way up to 37. And if I run the code, we can see here is the result. And in order to rotate the xtick labels, we should simply type ax, which means our axes. And our axes has a x-axis, so I simply type x-axis because you want to change something from the x-axis. And I want to set tick parameters, and the parameter that I want to change is the rotation, which I'm going to pass 45. And if I run the code, you can see now the xtick labels have been rotated.